My life is in your hands. My life is in your hands. You took control when I was young, when I was not able. My life is in your hands. My life is in your hands. You took control when I was young, when I was not able.
Hi, welcome to Inspired Blessings with Jimmy Prince, and today I'm doing an episode based on the fact that there's a rally here, and it's called Operation Underground Railroad, and it's about human trafficking, a topic that you would never think of. So this is episode one.
Guys, away from Long Island!
Before they were 12, and that's what sets them off on that path to be recruited. Now, my seven investigators, we've identified and interviewed over 220 girls since 2018 that are living in this life, that don't want to live in that life, that want to try and get out of that life and get some help. So we've partnered with different agencies, ECLI, an advocacy agency. All of our girls that we interview are introduced to an advocate. And what they do is they start a relationship and try and give them the support that they need, whether that's mental health, drug rehab, shelters. They say it best. They say they try and be what a best friend would be. So we could just do a little bit. They take it even further and work with them for years to try and get them out. Our first goal when we started this unit in 2017 was trying to be a part of that support system that these victims need. Because we thought if we were able to get them out of the life, sex trafficking is done. We get them out, there are no victims left. And maybe with the support of everybody here in the community understanding that it's going on, maybe we help the next generation to have the tools to stay out of this lifestyle. And then we end all of this crap. That's about all I have.
That's it.
So, Janet, if you could give me your full name, and you are actually the head volunteer for the Operation Underground Railroad here.
Yes, I'm the team leader for the Long Island chapter, New York. We're actually all tri-state area, covering New Jersey, Connecticut, Manhattan.
Okay. All right, now, how long ago did you volunteer, and what made you volunteer?
I started in 2018 when I had gone to a conference and saw the founder of Operation Underground Railroad. And his name is Tim Ballard, and he was a former Homeland Security agent that was tasked to go down and rescue these children from the deepest, darkest places, posing as a trafficker. And he found that he could do more by organizing his own non-for-profit organization. I heard him speak, and I knew that was my mission. I do a lot of volunteer work, and I love, that's part of me, and so I knew that there was something else I should be doing, and I immediately knew after hearing him that's what I needed to do.
Actually, I was listening to a video, and he was kind of explaining who he was and how he got involved, and how was Marty, the little boy?
Guardy was 8 years old when he was taken at his church where his father was a pastor, and to this day, he's never been found. But in the process of trying to find him, what happened was Guardy's father, he worked with him and their team, and they went in and they rescued all these 22 children, and but Guardy wasn't one of them. And when they left, they were happy, but at the same time they were really upset and sad, and that they couldn't find Guardy. And the incredible thing was that his father said to Tim, if I had never lost Guardy, these 22 kids would have never been found. So if I have to sacrifice that, then... And he ended up actually adopting several of the kids that they found. So it's a really incredible story.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. Like I said, I was watching it, and you can be able to watch it on YouTube. You know, because sometimes what makes a person start an organization, and it really had to touch him. You know, so for the fact that Tim Ballard and knew this father, this pastor, right, and they went down there and saw how important this job really was for people to do, and so you have ex-military, ex.
Yes, there's military, there's Navy SEALs, Homeland Security, law enforcement. They're all part of the operations that do that. And you know, they do this, but they do it side by side with law enforcement. They don't go on a mission unless they're invited in by law enforcement. And they make sure that there is a plan for after they rescue women and children, that they have a place safely to go to.
Well, thank you so much for volunteering. Thank you for it being your passion. And you know what, saving lives, especially innocent children, you know, and like I was sharing with you, how these, especially in a devastation scenario, whether it's a flood, an earthquake, that they set up these false orphanages.
And that's what happened.
Right. And so I had mentioned to you how this kind of, you know, tugs at my heart, because I was living in an orphanage for 5 years. Thank goodness that it was a Christian orphanage.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So that I just thank God every day for him saving me both physically and spiritually. But thank goodness for volunteers like you that now are making it a mission to save other, you know, other children that don't have people protecting them.
Thank you. And I'm one of 100 other demonstrations that are taking place today for World Day Against Trafficking of Persons Day.
And you did mention today on Facebook, what did you post?
4,000 victims have been found and saved.
Since when? When was it found?
2016. Yeah.
Praise God. Thank you. And your name is?
Stephanie Mercado.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
Why are you here? I'm here because I am taking a serious stand for children.
You know, I had interviewed a pastor who's very involved in Suffolk County, and also Fetty, who has this empowered organization in which they help human trafficked children. So I only found out about this probably maybe about 3-4 months ago. Had no idea, and it's big in Suffolk County. I hate to say the human trafficking.
It's very big. I actually only found out really 3 weeks ago, so I'm just
wide awake right now.
Surprised?
I'm very surprised, disgusted, upset, hurt, and I'm ready right now in my own community to just be my own voice, because if every person takes that stand in their life and starts communicating this message to others, we can really make a huge difference.
All right, so how do you feel, or what are the steps that you're going to take?
So basically, I have just been sharing my heart on social media. I actually messaged every single person in my phone today to tell them to please go look at my posts on Facebook, because it's not people's fault, but they are unaware, because our media is not covering this topic. Our media is not covering this topic. If you start doing your own research and investigating these things, you will find the truth to everything that's going on.
Right now, with everything going on, and I know what is going on because I listen to not mainstream news, but other news sites that are revealing the truth and why things are happening, because this stuff is happening behind the scenes that they don't want people to know about.
That's right. This, you won't see this on the TV anywhere in the country today, yet people are rallying all over the country today, but they will not cover it on the news because they do not want to stop this, because they are a part of the problem. And it is time for the people to take back their voice and power, and for us to come together. We need to unite as one in love and stand up for these children.
You know, it's you're surprised. I mean, people would be surprised. Hollywood, politicians, there's a lot of evil stuff going on.
If you watch The Fall of the Cabal, that'll start you down the rabbit hole, and then you will just do your own investigation. I tell everyone, 3 weeks ago, if you would have told me any of this stuff, I would have laughed at you and been like, no way, you're a conspiracy theory. I did my own research. I stayed up for nights. I am so passionate about helping. I have two girls at home, and I keep telling everyone in my life this. What if it was your kids? What if your daughter goes missing? Then you're going to care. People don't want to hear it when it's not in their yard, but the truth is, this is happening every 26 seconds, which means it is happening right over there, right now, and we don't know about it. So I am filled with passion for this. Every kid I'm walking today, and this is not an end for me. Like, I just hope more people start waking up and rising. Like, I'm just honored to be a part of this right now.
Are you familiar with a documentary that was called Out of the Shadow?
Yes, I've seen it as well.
You know what I mean?
Yes.
So you can actually watch it on YouTube, Out of the Shadow, and it's was done by two stuntmen from Hollywood that really investigated all the different things that are going on.
And a lot of these people who made these documentaries are not alive anymore. So, you know, there's a lot of very clear proof to things that are going on in the world today. And I am ready and willing to take a stand no matter what. I'm not going to sit in front of the TV and listen to fake news. I will not be blind. I will not sit around and let everyone else take a stand, because that is the attitude of why we are where we are right now. Because people are just like, oh, they'll take care of it and do it over there. It's not happening. It's happening in another country. No, it's happening the most in our country. And we have the most cush, relaxed life that we need to make a friggin' move for children. That's it.
And you know the thing. The thing is I'm grateful for President Trump, because when he got into office right away, he started to attack the human trafficking.
He did. Okay, so the media does a really great job at showing all the little clips on why we should not like Trump, but the facts are the facts. Trump can't be bought, and he is in it to fight this battle with us. And you know, I'm ready to see where this election goes. I'm praying that we're not trapped inside for a vote election, and that we can actually get out and take our freedom back.
Walk into vote. Do not mail in the ballots, because that's where the voter fraud comes in. So please, you know, there's riots going out there where destruction is happening, and people aren't wearing masks. They're not being required to wear masks. They're not wearing a mask. But you can wear a mask if you like and go vote, okay, and walk into vote, because if you really want your vote to count, you need to walk in to vote, okay?
Yes, if they have that mail-in vote, that's where that control is going to come in. It's going to be really easy for them to sway that vote and get what they want. You know, the vaccine, all these things are coming down the pipeline. Currency control. I could go on all day with you.
Oh, I could have a great conversation, because I know a lot. People call it conspiracy theory, but what I've realized is that conspiracy theories have actually been proven to be true, where the news media are really the conspiracy theory, because it's really been turned into lies.
There's just too much evidence. I mean, for Hillary Clinton to be on trial during the riots happening and nobody to know about it, like,
Obamagate
secret. Why are we hiding all this information? The facts are there, so the people really just need to do their own research.
Because mainstream media is owned by people that wants all that stuff hidden. So that's why. So what I like is that President Trump he says you can't tell the American people everything all at once, otherwise, you know, they'd be just overwhelmed. And so you got to do little drips at a time. So I hope when President Trump is talking, that you really listen to what he's saying. Because the mainstream media is telling you that he's bad, he's this, he's that, he's not doing anything right. But you know what? They're not telling you the truth. So do your own research and check for yourself.
Follow your heart, do your own research. Look at any child you know in your life and tell me that if it was your kid, that you would do nothing. That's it. That's the only question you need to ask yourself. And if we can all stand up together, we can do.
I listened to an X22 report.
I'm not familiar.
And also Red Pill 78. Okay.
Yeah.
So far, if I could recommend X22 report, and it's, you can watch it on YouTube, as well as Red Pill 78.
Little Miss Patriot on Instagram is really covering all of this very well. I suggest following her.
Thank you. Okay, so what are your names?
Tina.
I'm Billy.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
So, first of all, as we know, on your shirt here, it's the Operation Underground Railroad. The website for to find out more about the Operation Underground Railroad is?
It's OurRescue.org.
Okay, so it's OurRescue.org. So this way you can be able to see more about human trafficking and how far and wide it really is. So why are you here, and you know, why you also volunteers as well?
Yeah, it's been a subject matter we've been passionate about for so long, because so many people think that it's a conspiracy theory, and that's what kind of drives us so crazy, because when you have this cognitive dissonance where you can't get past some kind of old belief system, you don't even realize how many children right in your area. So many people think that it's other countries. It's right in your neighborhood where they're being kidnapped, they're being trafficked, they're suffering from abuse.
Yeah, we've been researching this for quite a while, and it's just, to me, I can't understand why people don't realize that this is really happening. This is something that's not, like Tina was saying, like they say conspiracy theory. It's not a conspiracy theory. It's actually really happening. It's almost like people don't want to look and see what's really going on out there, and that's why we wanted to come here to show our support for not only, you know, the children, but also our police who are doing their best to try to you know, stop this from happening. And the only ones who can stop this from happening is us coming to these
bringing awareness and having a voice for the children.
You know, I watched this documentary called Out of the Shadow, right? It was done by two stuntmen from Hollywood.
Yes.
And on there, they had said the word conspiracy theory came about because after John F. Kennedy was shot, the CIA, when people would say, I heard a gunshot here or this and that, and they would give different facts, but they turned that into saying, oh, it's just a conspiracy theory, because they want those people to look like they're crazy. So people today look at us as if we are crazy, even in my own family sometimes. But in reality, it's the truth.
Yes. Yeah.
So we are getting told lies on the mainstream media.
Oh, that mainstream media is a complete joke. It is completely biased, and it's not telling you the truth at all. It's actually telling you the complete opposite. And like you said, it's become this thing to cause a divide, and it's literally this manipulation that's force-fed to make this divide even stronger, and then throw around the conspiracy term, and then it doesn't even get brought into the light.
And just think about it. Yeah, the mainstream media doesn't talk about this at all. You never hear about it at all. Your congressmen and your senators, you rarely ever hear it at all. They just, all they want to do is argue about what their right is and what their left is. But that's not really the issue. The issue is all these children that are missing. 800,000, I believe, in the United States. But there's millions across the whole world. And, you know, it's time for us to rise up to help these children.
Yeah, and you know, when I watched the documentary based on human trafficking, and it was showing that a good percentage is from the parents that sell their children because their parents are on drugs, so they want to make money, and these children sometimes, they go to school regularly, but then on weekends, they sell their children out, and then now they come back to school, and it's just amazing that stuff like this happens.
Right, and not only that, like, they could be sold several times within a day.
Right.
They could be sexually abused up to sometimes 40 times in a day with different partners. I mean, and I think that's what's so extreme. People can't wrap their mind around it, so they immediately think that it's crazy.
You know, these innocent children.
What?
Innocent children, and oh my goodness, what I say is they're living hell on earth. Hell on earth for them. You know, to be put in that, here their innocence is taken away, and then they're just automatically abused all at once, over and over.
Yeah, and psychologically, these kids, you know, they think like it's almost, they know it's not normal, but in their mind, they make it normal that this is happening to them, because that's what happens. Your mind goes to a place of, where can I go to a safe place? But, you know, like Tina was saying, you know, sometimes they're trafficked 5-6 times a day. You know, so, you know, that's where we have to have this awareness.
I mean, and then you talk about suicide, right? You also talk about the fact that abortion.
Yeah.
you know, because I get pregnant.
Right. Well, you know, this is the problem. It goes all the way back. Yes, it, like, you know, these, you know, to bring up the thing with the abortions and everything, these, you know, like, we don't want to talk about it, but their organs are actually being sold. And that is just horrific. And this is a place where people don't want to go. They don't want to go and look at the information. But if you look at the information, this is really happening.
Say the website again.
It is ourrescue.org.
Yep. So you want to learn more about the Operation Underground Railroad, is go to ourrescue.org. And I hope you will, that it'll open your eyes and that you would think of speaking out for these innocent children. So, thank you.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Yeah, real quick, I believe if you go to operationontheground.org, if you just go on there and you put your name down, you can actually, there's a spot in there where you put your name and then you can actually...
It's actually Rise Up for Children.
Okay, right. Rise Up for Children.
If you go to riseupforchildren.com, so it's still affiliated, but riseupforchildren.com, you can literally just put your address in. They make it so easy. It'll tell you your legislators, and then there's a whole email sent out. You just hit send, takes 2 minutes, right. And then your legislators get to become aware, right, that this is a
really good day.
I actually did that today.
Yeah.
Awesome.
I did it 2 days ago, and that's the first step to have an awareness. So if you guys could do that, that would be great.
Yeah.
Yes. And they got a Facebook page.
And yes, there's a Facebook page, and Tim Ballard, who's the, you know, head guy, he has so many videos. If for people that think that this isn't real, you can go and see the actual footage of him undercover going in with teams, yeah, and rescuing.
You know, I was mentioning to Janet, being the fact that she's in charge of this, I said, you know, this touches my heart.
Yes.
Okay, because of the fact that I lived in an orphanage till I was 5 years old. I was adopted at two. I was found 2 days old in a bathroom in Korea. So, you know, God, I say, God, thank you, God, that He saved me both physically and spiritually. So, I think to myself, if I wasn't put in a Christian orphanage, you know, here are these fake orphanages that are being established after a traumatic, whether it's an earthquake or a flood or something like that, to get these innocent children, people dropping it off thinking, hey, you know, here, can you take care of this child? Oh, sure, we'll take care of this child.
You know, that's what breaks my heart, too, because I was just even telling my parents that so many of these kids come from foster care, from maybe drug abused households, or they were abused themselves. And so to just have that just be something that's a reality is heartbreaking when you think that there are organizations out there to help people, help these kids, and the opposite's happening.
Yeah.
No, that's true.
Yep. There's one more thing I wanted to say. On YouTube, if you want to do some research and get some awareness, there's a young woman who was sex trafficked and got away. Her name is Coco Berman, right? Is it Coco Berman?
I think that's her name, yeah.
If you go Coco and then Berman, I believe, she tells you everything that's going on. She tells you what happened to her, and that will give you, like, if you want to do research, that will give you an idea of what's really going on out there.
She survived, and so she tells her story.
Thank you so much for your time. And you know what? Here's the thing is that I'm praying, like, God, heal these children. You know, like, how do you get healed from a nightmare that went on and on and on? But only through Jesus,
right,
you know, that He can be able to do that.
And that's, yeah. So it's just holding such a high space of prayer that these children are saved, that are rescued, that are found, and then preventing from the future the numbers being so high, because the numbers are higher than they've ever been, especially in 2020.
A lot of wickedness.
Yeah.
And that's why a lot of chaos in this nation because of it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for joining me at this rally and Operation Underground Railroad and about human trafficking. As you can see, it's something wicked that should never happen. I mean, we talk about babies being aborted, you know, when I'm speaking at pro-life events. And I think to myself, there can be anything worse than that. Well, you know what? How about people actually being alive and being tormented and their will being taken away from them and being abused, their body being abused, not with their consent. So I hope you check out the website, and it's you can go to Operation Underground Railroad on Facebook, and in which the website will be there. But I'll also put it on above here so you can see it. And so thank you for joining me. And if you can be able to volunteer or go to any of their events, check out their website. And hopefully you'll tell more people about it so they are more aware of how bad human trafficking is. So thank you for joining me. And if you're looking for anybody to share their testimony at your church or event, I'd love to be able to share about how God saved me both physically and spiritually through my book, along with singing some songs in between. So if you can be able to like my Inspired Blessings Facebook page, as well as subscribe to my YouTube, and keep Inspired Blessings within arm's reach to help give you comfort when others are at a loss for words. Thank you, and God bless.
To accept and receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, please say this prayer. I know that I am a sinner who needs forgiveness. Jesus, please forgive me for all my sins and purify me. I know that you died and rose again to pay for my sins. I need you to be my Lord and Savior for the rest of my life. Thank you in the name of Jesus. Amen.
With man, this is impossible, but with God, all things are possible.
Go to jeanmarieprince.com. That's jeanmarieprince.com. Thank you so much, and God bless. For more information about Jean Marie Prince and Inspired Blessings, please go to jeanmarieprince.com.
My life is in your hands. My life is in your hands. You took control when I was young, when I was not able. I had no mother to love me or a father to give me a hug. I was left all alone in this strange darkness. Nobody tried to claim me or said that they knew me. But Lord, you were always there watching over me, making sure that I was fed. You kept me from the cold. Your hands picked me up and brought me to a loving home. Your grace was poured on me, and I was chosen to be saved. My life is in your hands. My life is in your hands. You took control. Lord, you bless.